Like many of the fundamental forces of nature, we take it for granted. However, without it, we would be lost. Literally, lost in space. Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions. I'm Rebecca Felgate, and today we're asking, what if the world lost gravity for 1 minute? When discussing gravity and our spinning planet Earth, many people use the analogy of the weight on a string. Imagine swinging a weight on a string around your head. Gravity is the grip we have on that string. If we were to let it go, the weight would go flying off in one direction. Bye! Say goodbye to our mates, the lakes and rivers. The ocean will also start to fly away, although 60 seconds may not be enough time for a complete drainage. Most concerning is that Earth's atmosphere would float away too, leaving us with little breathable air. It isn't just the bodies of water and their inhabitants that are in jeopardy. Anything not attached to the Earth will float away too. Cars, buses, trains, aeroplanes, animals, and of course, people. The faster something floats away depends on whether or not it was mid-motion when the gravity is stopped. If gravity was gone for just 1 minute, it would not be enough time for structures attached to the Earth to be affected, so people inside buildings would be better off than those outdoors. Of course, it is better to be a helium balloon lost inside a building. Indoor people would float upwards to the ceiling, although it would be pretty crowded up there, what with all the furniture and the room appliances joining them. It would also be very hard to move, as without gravity, there is nothing really to push against. Despite losing gravity for just 1 minute, the loss would have an effect on the moon, which is positioned as it currently is by gravity. Without Earth drawing the moon with its gravity, it would begin to float away, which would affect our tides if we had any left. If humans were subjected to longer periods without gravity, our bodies would change too. We would lose muscle strength and bone mass like astronauts do after long periods in space. If our Earth was exposed to a long period without gravity too, it would start to break up, piece off, and float into space. This would be one heck of an earthquake season, if anyone was alive to witness it. Although as our question is just for 1 minute, we need to assume that these things would not have time to happen. If gravity was turned back on after 60 seconds, things that had not left our Earth yet would come smashing back down with a bang. Cue much death and destruction. Our question focuses on the world, but let's extend beyond this for a moment and think about the universe. Without gravity for an extended period of time, suns would explode, solar systems would not exist, galaxies would not exist, planets would break up and float away in bits, and then eventually, those bits would break up too. Really, it would be a crazy casserole of space chunks thinning out until we just have atoms and molecules floating about. You see, without gravity, things just don't work. Gravity is one of the four fundamental forces of nature that make up our universe, and things just simply wouldn't exist without it. Because of the fundamental nature of gravity, asking questions like this one we've just answered is fun for a flight of fancy, but in practice has no grounding. Excuse the pun. So long as mass exists, there will always be gravity. So long as the world is here, the world being a ball of mass, we will always have gravity. So long as the sun has mass, we will always be held by gravity in our solar system. So don't worry, we're staying put until the sun loses its mass and therefore its gravitational pull when it explodes in a few billion years. But don't worry, there are plenty of other more important questions that need answering between now and then. So guys, this is one question answered for you. Did I leave anything out? As always, I enjoy it when you continue the debate in the comments section down below. Thank you guys for tuning into this episode of Life's Biggest Questions. If you liked it, please do leave me a thumbs up, and also turn on the notification bell so you can stay up to date with our channel. I'm Rebecca Felgate, I'll catch you in the next video, but for now, stay curious, stay alert, and never ever stop questioning.